Here is Windows 10 running in VirualBox within a RAM disk. And let's test the speed by restarting and seeing how fast Windows 10 comes back up. That was pretty quick, wasn't it? A RAM disk is faster than a SSD. And here we can just go ahead and open up some applications like GIMP 2. GIMP is now running. How about Lazarus? Almost instantaneous. Open Office, a text document, spreadsheet, presentation, Firefox, just to show that you could have different version of Windows operating. Here is Windows 98 running in a virtual machine on the RAM disk. Let's try restarting this. That was quick. There aren't too many programs here on Windows 98. Things run very quickly. Oh, there's AOL and CompuServe and Prodigy. Wow. Maybe try Internet Explorer. Well, the errors come up pretty quick. All right, and there's the web page finally loaded. I'll just shut this down. So let's go ahead and take a look at installing Windows 10 in a virtual machine on a RAM disk. The software used is ImDisk 2.0.9, which is a free download, VirualBox 5.2.6, which is a free download, and Windows 10 and 98. Windows 10 ISO is a free download at Microsoft's website. In a previous tutorial, Linux disk images were run in a RAM disk, and I just wanted to see if Windows 10 would work also. Found out that much more RAM had to be used for Windows 10 than Linux, which is no surprise. The RAM allocation is as follows. The computer that was used has 32 gigs of RAM installed in it. 16 gigabytes was allocated for the RAM disk, 8 gigabytes was allocated to run Windows 10 in VirtualBox, and 8 gigabytes was allocated to run the computer. We'll find that the RAM disks are faster than the solid-state drives. The speed of the RAM disk depends upon the speed of the computer's RAM. For this tutorial, an i7-4790 3.6 GHz with 1600 RAM was used. Please do not use all the computer's RAM for the RAM disk. RAM disks will not hold data when the computer is off or restarted. If installing programs for RAM disk is a good idea to uninstall the programs or back up the RAM disk before restarting the computer. If a program that was on a RAM disk is lost, basically what you need to do is recreate the RAM disk with the same drive letter and then install the program to the RAM disk and then uninstall the program. Okay, here is Microsoft's website where we can get the Windows 10 installation media, the ISO. We'll click on Download Tool Now and Save File. Go to the download area and run Media Creation Tool. Accept and select Create Installation Media. Here are the options for Windows 10. We can select the language, edition, architecture. I'm going to keep this as recommended options. Go to next. We want ISO file, next. Select where we want to save it. I'll save it to the desktop. Okay, the ISO is now downloaded. I'll click on finish. And I'll go ahead and install VirualBox. VirualBox runs virtual machines, so we'll need this to run Windows 10. VirualBox was downloaded from virtualbox.org. I will install this on the computer's hard drive. Okay, here in VirualBox, we'll go ahead and go to New. We want Windows 10. I'll put in 64. Click on Next. Here I'll allocate about 8 gigs of RAM. Next. Create a virtual hard disk now. VDI is fine. Next. Dynamically allocated. Next. And I'll save this to the desktop so I can find it easy. I'll click on Create. Go into the settings. Under System, I'll select Processor. This computer has 4 cores. I'll select 3 cores to run Windows 10, and 1 core will run the computer. I'll then go to Storage. Go to the CD-ROM area here, click on the disk, select Choose Virtual Optical Disk File. I'll select the Windows ISO that I downloaded to the desktop, click on Open, OK, and now we're ready to install. I'll click on Start. I'll have the settings as English, keyboard US, next, install now. I don't have a product key, so I'll select that. And I'll go with Windows 10 Pro. Next, accept, next. I'll go into custom, drive 0, next. Don't press any key to boot from the ISO. Just let the computer continue to run. Okay, select your region, keyboard layout. I'll skip the second keyboard. I'll set up for personal use. I'll have an offline account. No, I don't care to do this. Windows 10 64 will be the name for the PC. I'm not going to create a password for this. You can if you want. No. If you want Cortana, go right ahead. And I'll just turn these off. And accept. You can put any settings you want into your own computer. Okay, Windows 10 is now installed. I'll right mouse click on the CD and click on Remove Disk from Virtual Drive. That'll get rid of the ISO. I'll then shut down Windows 10. I'll go into VirtualBox, click in the settings, and I'll double check to make sure that the CD is empty of the ISO. I'll close down VirtualBox, and then I will uninstall it. I'll go into the control panel and go into add remove programs. I'll go to VirtualBox, right mouse click, uninstall. I've already installed ImDisk, which makes the RAM disk. We could find ImDisk in the control panel. Here we have ImDisk virtual disk driver. I'll click on Mount New. The size of the virtual disk will be 16 gigabytes. I'll have the drive letter set to R. You can set the settings to however you wish. I'll click on OK. And then we need to format the disk. Once the disk is formatted, the RAM disk is ready to be used. Now what I'm going to do is go into the File Explorer. I'm going to go ahead and install VirtualBox to the RAM disk. Go ahead and browse. The folder name is Drive R with the folder VirtualBox. Okay, next, next, yes, install. Okay, VirtualBox is now installed to local disk R. I'm going to take the Windows 10 virtual disk image and dump it into local disk R, the RAM disk. This computer has a 7200 RPM hard drive, so it may take a few minutes to transfer over. Okay, now that Windows 10 is in the RAM disk, we find that the size of Windows 10 right now is about 10 gigabytes. So that means that we have about 6 gigabytes for other things. And remember, Windows 10 always likes to update itself. It is not a good idea to overfill the RAM disk, because if you do, the virtual disk image will cease to operate. In that case, you would have to take the disk image out of the RAM disk, unmount the RAM disk, make a larger RAM disk to hold more information. Okay, now that we got Windows 10 64 in there, I'm going to go to VirtualBox. I'm going to right mouse click on Windows 10 64, and I'm going to remove Windows 10 64, and I'm going to click on Delete All Files. I'm now going to click on New, put in Windows 10 64, Next, allocate about 8 gigabytes for RAM. Next, and here, use an existing virtual hard disk file. I'll go ahead and choose the hard disk file from local disk R, the RAM disk. Click on Create. Then I'll go into Settings, and I'll allocate how many processors I want. So I'll allocate 3 cores to the virtual disk and 1 core to the computer. I'll go ahead and start. And now we have Windows 10 running in the RAM disk.